Mr. Sarnes is staff counsel for the Center for Democracy and Technology, a Washington, D.C.-based organization with expertise in law, technology, and policy that seeks practical solutions to enhance free expression and privacy in global communications technologies. Welcome.
Thank you, Chairwoman Velasquez, Ranking Member Chabot. First, let me say thanks for inviting me to participate here on behalf of the Center for Democracy and Technology. CDT is a nonprofit public interest group dedicated to preserving privacy, civil liberties, and other democratic values in the digital age, and we've been a leader on privacy and closely related data security and data retention issues. So we're very happy to be able to offer our views on the privacy and security questions raised by the proposal that's the subject of today's hearing. CDT believes that the proposal could have serious consequences for data privacy and data security, particularly in the case of small businesses. First, there's the issue concerning Social Security numbers of sole proprietors and other individuals engaged in small-scale business activity. The proposal would require banks and other payment processors to keep track of merchants' taxpayer identification numbers, or TINs. And for sole proprietors and other individual business people, the TIN will often be the individual's Social Security number, as Chairwoman Velasquez noted in her opening statement. So for these individuals, the proposal will mean that their Social Security numbers will be stored and linked to further personal information about them in corporate databases that today don't keep that information. The reason that's significant is that, in the words of the President's Identity Theft Task Force, which issued a report last year, the Social Security number is the most valuable commodity for identity thieves. And the more parties and the more databases where that commodity is held, the greater the risk that it could fall into the wrong hands. In recent years, we've seen virtually a constant stream of high-profile data breaches at institutions of all kinds, corporations, educational institutions, and government agencies. And that's why the federal government has established a clear policy of trying to move away from and reduce the use and storage of Social Security numbers. Now, to their credit, the merchant banks seem to recognize this risk. Their standard practice today for banks issuing merchant accounts is to discard the merchant's TIN as soon as the account is approved. And this is consistent with the widely accepted privacy principle called data minimization. The principle is really pretty simple. It just means only collect the data you really need and only keep it for as long as you need it. Banks are following that principle today regarding TINs and Social Security numbers of sole proprietors. And CDT does not believe that Congress should force them to abandon that kind of sound privacy practice, as this proposal would force them to do. Second, the proposal may well entail other types of expanded data collection from small business owners, sometimes reporting the aggregate amount of credit card receipts from a particular merchant account can paint an incomplete or misleading picture. And when that happens, it's easy to predict what's going to happen next. There will be pressure to provide more detailed information. For example, you could have small businesses that share a merchant account. Think about flea market sellers who are neighbors at the flea market. In these kinds of cases, the aggregate amount reported will say little about what the actual revenues or profits of those businesses are, and so it's likely to lead for pressure for the IRS to ask for a more detailed breakdown of that information, which would mean significantly more tracking by the banks of their merchants' activities than occurs today. So anyway, the point on this is simply that before Congress adopts any new proposal here on this topic, it really should carefully explore the additional types of data collection that would likely be demanded as part of any new reporting system. The final concern I want to mention is that the proposal would set a dangerous precedent. CDT is actually very concerned that if this proposal is enacted, it could encourage additional government efforts to enlist private sector intermediaries in tracking the behavior of their customers. For example, if the federal government goes this direction, it's easy to imagine that state governments might try to follow suit and impose tax reporting obligations of their own. Other types of data retention requirements that have been proposed in the past and that could get an unwarranted boost here would be proposals to have internet service providers, for example, track the browsing behavior of their entire customer base simply because something might someday prove of interest to law enforcement. CDT objects to those proposals and would hate to see them get encouragement from congressional action on this subject. So for all these reasons, CDT believes that this committee and Congress should pay careful attention to the data privacy and security concerns that this proposal raises, and in light of those concerns, really should put a heavy burden of proof on the proponents of the proposal to show that it's effective, that it's necessary, and that it's better than possible alternatives. Thanks again for the opportunity to testify.